Well, I have a saying, there's nothing like the sound of an excavator warming up in the morning at a recovery site.
Taneum Creek is a tributary of the Yakima River about 11 miles northwest of Ellensburg, Washington. Here, they're replacing a decades-old diversion with a more fish-friendly structure.
So the roughened channel is as natural as we can make it to pass fish but maintain a fixed concrete structure for irrigation, which is also very important in Kittitas County.
This project is part of a huge effort to restore habitat and improve stream flows in the Yakima River Basin. And one of its main goals is to help the little guys.
It's the little fish that are a limiting factor in salmon recovery. In the main stem Yakima, because the water's so fast, about the only habitat that they can survive in is the edge habitat, which is not ideal for spawning and rearing.
Anadromous fish rely on a certain flow regime during critical times in their life cycles, and flows in the Yakima River are regulated by the need for irrigation water downstream. So this project helps get fish past a barrier and into the tributaries where there's habitat they can thrive in.
Some fish that we would say were strong and lucky did make it upstream past the old dam, but now we're going to meet the state-of-the-art type of design. And of course, I keep in the back of my mind the big picture that this is the last impediment to fish passage in Taneum Creek, and then they have unrestricted access to 30 miles of excellent habitat upstream, which in the region is substantial.
With the original structure, the fish encountered a 3 or 4 foot drop, which was impassable for most fish. The new structure is a semi-natural passage route that will help fish pass easily up and downstream. It's also designed to be stable in a 100-year flood. Yet restoring fish populations in the Yakima Basin isn't as simple as just taking out diversions. It requires a multi-dimensional effort.
You could fix all the passage barriers, but at certain times of the year, the irrigators have the right to take virtually the entire stream flow. So if there's no water, it doesn't matter if there's a barrier or not, you're not going to get fish out.
So restoration projects like these also include water conservation and flow enhancement activities, like purchasing water rights and dedicating them in stream, and funding pipelines and sprinkler conversions. The saved water is then put into a water trust where it's protected for the stream, and ultimately, improved flows and smarter water use benefit fish and water users alike.
You have to make it a good thing for them. In this case, their water delivery techniques will be streamlined. You're going to have an automated gate system. So it creates benefits for everybody.
What a lot of the irrigators and farmers are finding is that with these new systems, they actually have an easier time of getting water out onto their fields. It's just made life easier for them. So naturally, they're happy. Happy farmers, happy fish. Mm-hmm.